I'm Tao Hong from the University of North Carolina, Charlotte. I'm the director of the Big Data Energy Analytics Laboratory, or Big Deal. We conduct applied research to discover actionable insights from energy data. A large portion of our research project is on energy forecasting, such as forecasting the renewable generation and demand and prices of electricity and gas. Electricity demand forecasting, or better known as load forecasting by the power industry, is the area I'm most interested in. This is a fascinating area, not only to the power and energy society, but also to the forecasting community. The primary product of the power industry is electricity. The power companies move the electrons through the grid to end users. There are two features that make the electric supply chain very different from other supply chains, such as in manufacturing and retail. Number one, the electrons travel really fast at the speed of light. Number two, there is not yet a practical solution for bulk storage of electricity. Therefore, the supply and demand has to be balanced in real time. To operate and plan the system, we have to understand when, where, and how much the electricity is spread throughout the system. Without accurate forecast, we as end users may experience increasing rates, brownouts, or even blackouts. That's why load forecasting is crucial to the power industry. Obviously, we need a load history. Because a large portion of the load is used for heating and cooling, we need weather data. Since consumption patterns change based on the work schedule, working hours, holidays, and special event information is also important. When a system experiences outages dragging down the load level, we use the outage logs. For long-term load forecasting, we need to add economic information and sometimes demographic data. To improve the forecast accuracy, we can also leverage hierarchical information, such as weather and load data collected at higher frequency timing and more granular geographic regions. Compared to classic demand or sales data, the electricity demand data can be much higher resolution, both temporally and spatially. For instance, many research activities today are to forecast load at the meter level, which utilizes 15-minute interval data from thousands of meters. At an aggregated level, the electricity demand typically presents the seasonality by month of a year, day of a week, and hour of a day. Typical residential loads are highly driven by weather. In contrast, some industrial loads may show very random patterns that are not much dependent on weather. I believe that the only way to measure the success is whether the method has been widely used by the industry. I can name some of those successful ones. In late 1990s, the Electric Power Research Institute sponsored a project to develop a short-term load forecasting system based on neural networks. The resulting product is still being used by many power companies today. In the recent decade, Rob Hindman and Shu Fan developed their methodology from several projects sponsored by Australian Energy Market Operator. Their work is now in an R package called MEFM, or Monash Electricity Forecasting Model. The research from my doctoral dissertation was sponsored by a US utility company. In early 2010s, it was commercialized by the software company SAS and then deployed worldwide. Most of my recent developed load forecasting methodologies are also being used by power companies. To help recognize and promote the method that can potentially be successful, we organized two global energy forecasting competitions in 2012 and 2014. The winning methods and the data sets were published by the International Journal of Forecasting. We hope the researchers can leverage those data sets and use them for benchmarking purposes. I will say that each successful method is a simple solution to a real-world problem. Once the real-world problem is solved, the level of success is dependent upon the simplicity of the solution. Know that simple does not mean trivial. A simple solution can be quite powerful. Some level of sophistication is necessary to achieve high accuracy. But industry may not need the most accurate forecast anyway. Those successful methods typically find a good balance between simplicity and accuracy. I believe that the key to success in load forecasting is partnership with the industry. The industry partner can help ensure the problem we are solving is a problem of practical interest. The successful method I named earlier were all born from industry-sponsored projects. Having a trustworthy industry partner will put you halfway to the success.